Faith is a choice. Preacher J. Vernon McGee told a true story about a friend of his who was a college professor. And they were talking one day, and the professor said to him, "You know, McGee, I really envy the faith that you have. I wish I could have a faith like you, but I have intellectual doubts, so I can't." McGee went on to say later on, "The truth is, this man was having an affair with one of his students. So it wasn't that he couldn't have faith, but he chose not to have faith in order to distance himself from God that he might keep his lifestyle." Our actions reveal what we truly believe. But it's also true that many people choose what they will believe based upon the lifestyle they want to live. I remember many years ago when I was a freshman in college, going away from home for the first time. I noticed lots of good boys and girls suddenly changing. People sleeping around, taking drugs, and declaring that they no longer believed in God. I wondered what could account for this big change in so many young adults. I thought about it, and there were a couple of things going on. For one, they were now attending classes that were openly hostile to Christianity and the Bible. But also, many of them were away from home for the first time, out from under mommy and daddy's rules. Which do you think accounted for the big change? I'm convinced that it was the second one. While only God can give true faith for salvation, it's also true that based upon everything we see in creation, as well as the authenticity of the Bible, as well as our own conscience, that every one of us is without excuse if we say we do not believe in God. Joshua 24:17 says, "Choose today whom you will serve." Remember, what you believe says a lot more about your heart than your mind.